Power Rangers Lightning Collection fans, this is Reddish Power, and I'm back at the Spotlight of the Reviewing Station, finally back at the real Spotlight of the Reviewing Station, to bring you this exciting exclusive figure that just arrived here from Target.com. Took a couple days for it to ship here, but once I got my notice, oh boy, did I get really excited for this one. I'm all pumped. Let's do this. This is the Andros figure, which I'm not familiar with this appearance at all throughout Power Rangers in Space. I'm sure it's a certain episode, but I don't want to get into that argument. Let's save it for another time. Maybe. Anyway, let's put the figure aside for a moment and take a look at the packaging here, which is your common Power Rangers Lightning Collection displayable packaging, which is beautiful artwork as usual. I wish I could give credit to the guy who does this, but I've seen his Twitter posts where he always updates his gallery with all these lovely artworks from all the waves that he's been working on. I just keep forgetting the name. It keeps slipping my tongue for some reason. Just foreign plus on this side, the rest of that lovely artwork with the two earrings right there, which is common for Andros. Power Rangers in Space logo right there. Kind of hard to see it, but there it is. On the other side, we've got that artwork again of Andros. On the back, we've got the computer image of the figure. That it is a computer image because of the robe, which the real one looks nothing like that. Oh well. Nothing else to really say here except there's our little sad onion face. Very disturbing. And at the bottom, just a barcode in case you want to pause the viewer and get an idea here. There you go. That's about it. Just going to put this aside now and bring back. Now, just to let you guys know that a majority of this video is just going to be a side-by-side comparisons with the very first in-space Red Ranger figure, which is right here, just to show it off. The real difference is that he's in his Ranger uniform and this is some kind of disguise. Maybe he's a secret agent or something. I don't know. But anyway, you can remove this robe. And as you saw, this robe looks nothing like the one on the back of the box. Because, well, let's talk terms here. This is reality speaking here, but whatever. I mean, this is a very thick material. Maybe they could have gone with something a little lighter, something that would actually fit a lot better around the figure. Maybe even a little more to his circumference, I guess you could say, because this is pretty bulky on the figure and it does look like a bathrobe. I'm not going to joke about that. It feels actually pretty smooth. I dig that, but it kind of looks like also a carpet got torn up and stitched together into this. All joking aside, though, let's take a look at the inside real quickly. You can see the nasty stitching here. As you would come to expect. Better on the inside than on the outside, which looks good. And then we got this little Velcro piece that keeps this together, which, when it works, and that's pretty strong, too. This is just a blank in-space male ranger body. It's not exactly black, red, blue, silver. No, it's just a blank buck. So if you want to make, like, custom figures out of this mold, you could. I wouldn't, because this figure is going for a heavy price right now because he's so rare. I am not sure if this is just a complete repackage of the first one, but I've got it right here, so you can, get an idea for yourself. It does kind of look like the same head. Maybe the print job's a little better on this one here, as you would come to expect with time. But, yeah. I mean, I dig it. It looks good. He's got the gold trim here for his buckle, which is nice. And then, of course, he comes with his Astro Blaster, which is nicely painted again. The wrong color blue, but hey, at this point, it doesn't really matter, as long as they keep it cohesive. But there's really not that much to talk about here, especially this symbol here on his chest. I don't know what that's supposed to be. Maybe it's the symbol of hope for his planet on KO35, right? Anyway, let's do this. Got the articulation to get to. We got the ball joint. We got the hinge at the neck. We've got your appendage shoulder joints, which are very free-moving, which I dig. Full rotation. Got the butterfly joint. Got the bicep. Double-jointed elbows. Wrist rotation. Hinge joint. We've got the ball-jointed upper torso. We got ab crunch. We've got this. His belt can move because it's very loose on the figure. Ball joints at the hips. Get that much kicking forward. That much going back, which isn't much. And no split, but hey, that's okay. We've got the thigh swivel cut. Double jointed knees, which are very good on this guy. Rotation at the cuff of the boots. We've got hinge joint for up and down movement at his ankles. And we also have the lovely ankle rocker pivot. So now that we got the figure out of the way, what do you say we go ahead and look at some of his accessories he comes with, such as this blank Ranger helmet. And I mean blank. Like, I wasn't aware that there was no detail whatsoever. No raised pattern for the outline of the visor. So this print job here, man, this is what you call a lucky shot, because if this white wasn't here, this would be completely blank just like this, and it would just look weird on the Red Ranger helmet. But yeah, that's basically what it is. It's just an in-space helmet. I don't know which Ranger. It's just a blank. It's very tight on the figure. I might have to apply some shock oil, because I'm afraid that this might actually tear off the joint, because that is, ooh, that's very tight. That is really scaring me there. Let's look at some of his other accessories. He's got his spiral saber. No different from the original. Nothing at all. Which is fine. I like it when there's consistency. Consistency is always a good thing, in my opinion. He can hold it pretty well. He's not going to drop it anytime soon. Andros also includes some alternate hands if you want to switch him out with a balled up fist, or maybe one where he could actually do something pretty amazing here. You get this little blast effect piece that you could either put on the tip of the Astro Blaster, or what I like to do just for shits and giggles. Check it out. Lightning finger. Final accessory the figure comes with is just a lightning effect piece that can slap over the spiral saber, which does look good in the translucent yellow. I dig it. Works great. While I have no idea where this comes from in any episode of Power Rangers in Space throughout the entire series, I will say this much, though. If you want to recreate the opening to Power Rangers in Space, the very first episode where Andros is in that party with all the evil space aliens, as Dark Spectre is giving away his plans to capture Zordon and rule the universe or something like that, you can pull it off. It looks really good, in my opinion, especially when you've got the entire helmet covered over. The only thing that we're missing is, well, we need some villains, right?
He's a spy!
How'd you know? Let's get to the size comparisons portion of this video. Here is Andros compared to Andros. Here he is with Astronema. Here he is with Ashley. Here he is with Carlos, Maxwell Jacob Freeman, Kingdom Scorponok, and finally Sonic the Thing of Nightmares. Andros' return to the Lightning Collection was a surprise, actually. I was not expecting Hasbro to pull this one off at all. I did not see this coming at all. However, even though I don't have any recollection of where this particular style came from the series, I will say it is a must-own. It is a really good figure with a completely blank buck if you want to use for customs. Okay, I'm giving you guys some ideas here. If you're not into these random one-off choices for the Lightning Collection, you could always use this to make custom Power Ranger figures, which, you know, you have my blessing for, I guess. The likeness to the actor is pretty good. The articulation is superb, as it always is for the Lightning Collection. Accessories count is worthwhile. And I gotta say, he's really donning it pretty good with this bath robe. But other than that, I think I'm gonna go ahead and wrap this up. So if you see him in Target, pick him up. Don't pass him up. Especially if you want to buy two and sell one off of eBay. Hey, I'm just giving you guys some ideas here because he is going for a lot at the moment because this is a very hard figure to come by. But if somehow you can pull it off, he's well worth it adding to your collection, in my opinion. So with that, if you have any questions or comments, you know what to do. Feel free to leave them down below in the comment section of this video. If you enjoyed it, hit the thumbs up button. And until next time, this is Red is Power signing off by saying, Lightning Fingers are awesome.